Hello students, this is Sriram Triveni, lecturer in botany. Today I will discuss about the topic the taxonomic description about the flower parts. So the taxonomic terminology of the flower parts. So in the taxonomy of the families, you have to know about the flower structure carefully. Without knowing the terminology, you cannot grow through the families. So the important of the families is very important in taxonomy, so that this video lesson is useful for the good understanding purpose of taxonomy families. Okay, ma'am. So first of all, you have to know the structure about the flower. So what is a flower? A flower is a defined as modified reproductive shoot of determinant growth. Okay, here microsporophylls, megasporophylls, that termed as stamens, carpels, like that. Okay, this is a ovary. In that flower, this is a ovary. Okay, this is the pedicel. Petals are there, and these are the stamens. And this is the style, and this is the stigma. These are the stamens, and these are the filaments. These are the stamens, these are anthers. Okay, these are the filaments. Ovary, petals, style, stigma, anther, filaments. Okay, ovary. In that ovary, ovule is there. Ovules are there. This is a pedicel. This is the structure of flower. So different terms related to flower. So first of all, what is a complete flower and what is incomplete flower, you have to know. Why? Because in the taxonomy description, you have to write a flower characters of all the families. So what is a complete flower and what is incomplete flower? A complete flower is a flower that has all four parts of the flower. What is the main parts? That are sepals, petals, andrecium and gynecium. This is a complete flower. Complete flower. So usually the complete flowers are bisexual flowers. Bisexual flowers. In this slide you have to know, this is the pedicel, these are the sepals, this is the ovary, ovules are there, these are the filaments, anthers, style and stigma, petals. Okay, all are present. So sepals, petals, andrecium and the gynecium. Andrecium means stamens, that means filament and anther. Okay, ma, filament and anther. So that this is a complete flower. So bisexual flower referred to as a complete flower. Next one is incomplete flower. So a complete flower contains all the four organs, all the four parts, while an incomplete flower is missing at least one. So a bisexual or perfect flower has both the stamens and carpels. Okay, and a unisexual, that means imperfect, flower either lacks stamens and is called carpellate, or lacks carpels and is called as staminate. Here the staminate and pistillate flowers are there. In the staminate flowers, pistil is absent, pollen pistil is absent, that is style stigma. So here staminate flowers, stamens are present. Okay, stamens are present. In the pistillate flowers, okay, here pistillate flowers, only ovule, ovary, style, stigma are present. Absence of stamens. Okay, this is pistillate flower. This is staminate flower, stamens are present. In the pistillate flower, ovules, ovary, style, stigma are present. These are unisexual flowers. Only one sex organ are present in a single flower. So bisexual flowers refers to as complete flowers, and the unisexual flowers refer to as incomplete flowers. This is very important for remember for writing the floral characters of the family members. Okay, what is a complete flower and what is incomplete flower? Next one, symmetry of a flower. Symmetry of a flower is very very important. So depending upon the symmetry of the flower, it is defined to as two important types. That is, first one is actinomorphic flowers and second one is zygomorphic flowers. Actinomorphic flower is also known as regular flowers, and zygomorphic flowers are known as irregular flowers. So coming to the actinomorphic flower, flowers that are radially symmetrical so that they are able to bisect it into similar orbs in more than one vertical plane, forming a mirror images. So here a actinomorphic flower is, you have to cut like this. This is off part. Okay, two hand off and two hand off like this. If you cut like this plane, this two hand off and these are the two hand off. So flowers that are radially symmetrical so that they are able to bisect it into similar halves. So cut at any position or any plane, you have to forming a mirror images. That is called as actinomorphic flower. Okay, actinomorphic flower. And the second one is zygomorphic flower. Flowers that are bilaterally symmetrical so that they are able to bisect it into similar orbs in only one plane. Only one plane, forming mirror images. So zygomorphic flowers can cut only in one plane and forming mirror images. In actinomorphic flower, cut at any plane, more than one vertical plane, forming mirror images. Zygomorphic flower means similar orbs in only one plane, like this. These two orbs and these are the two orbs. Okay, this is a zygomorphic flower. And asymmetric flower, here there is no equality. If you cut like this, this 3 and 2, an incomplete. Okay, this type of symmetry is a asymmetric symmetry. So actinomorphic flower is radially symmetrical like this. Zygomorphic flower is bilaterally symmetrical. Bilaterally symmetrical. Next, cyclic flowers. Most of the angiosperms having cyclic flowers. Cyclic means a flower those parts are arranged in a whorl. Cyclic flowers are characteristics of most flowering plants, including Liliaceae, Caryophyllaceae and Solanaceae. These are the example for the cyclic flowers. And acyclic flowers. A flowers those parts are arranged in a spiral rather than in whorls as in magnolias. Next, spirocyclic flowers. It is present in Nymphaeaceae family. It is flower where half of the members are arranged spirally and half of the members are arranged in oral. Okay, ma? So, here are the pictures showing. In a different manner of sepals, and petals are there. Some are present in whorl and some are present in rose. Pistillate and staminate flowers. What is pistillate and what is staminate flowers? Unisexual flowers or imperfect flowers that bears only one sex organs means it bears stamens or pistils, either present stamens or either presence of pistils. If stamens are present, those are called as staminate flowers. If pistils are present, that flower is called as pistillate flowers. So only one sex organ is present. Unisexual are imperfect flowers that bear stamens only are called staminate flowers. So stamens are the male sex organs, so that this is called as male flowers. And pistillate flowers, the unisexual are imperfect flowers that bear pistils only are called pistillate flowers or female flowers. So next, coming to the next term, that is monoecious and dioecious. This plant is monoecious and this plant is a dioecious. Generally we tell like that. But what is monoecious and what is dioecious, we have to know carefully. So monoecious plants are those in which both the staminate and the pistillate flowers are borne and the same plant. So monoecious, mono means single. So in the single plant, both the male and female sex organs are present. So that means staminate and pistillate flowers are both on the same plant. That is called as monoecious. And dioecious, species in which the two imperfect flowers are borne separately in different plants are called as dioecious. For example, borassus. So in this dioecious, di means two. So both the male and female parts, these two parts are present in different plants. Okay. In the monoecious, present on single plant or same plant. In the dioecious, the male and female sex organs are present in different plants. So here in the dioecious, male plant is different from the female plant. Some plants bear male, female and bisexual flowers are called as polygamous flowers. For example, lychee sinensis. Next one is a term we generally use, it perianth. What is a perianth of flower? The perianth is the outer envelope enclosing a flower and is made up of fiber. An outer calyx and the inner corolla, or a calyx or a corolla, or calyx and corolla combined and undifferentiated from one another. It is generally termed as perianth. Calyx, both the calyx and corolla combined and undifferentiated from one another, is called as the term perianth. Okay, the corolla of the flower is divided up into petals, whereas the calyx is made up or sepals. If the calyx and corolla are combined into one undifferentiated unit, then the individual parts are referred to as tepals, that are called as tepals. Here petals and sepals and petals are there. In some flowers, petals and sepals combine together and form a tepals. They use the term tepals, and perianth, the term is perianth. See, these are the sepals, these are the petals, these are the sepals, these are the petals. But in this slide, these are the sepals and petals combined together and form a perianth. So simply we call it as tepals. So parts of a typical flower. A flower consists of an axis known as thalamus. This is the thalamus. Okay. On which four differentiated sets of floral parts are inserted. Thalamus is the receptacle or terminal part of the axis of a flower. Sometimes it is long, showing distinct internodes. What is calyx? So in many plant species, the calyx consists of green leaf-like structures and used as a term. The sepals, which protect the delicate inner parts of the flower. Okay, the protection, it gives the protection to the flower parts while it is developing and prevent it from desiccating. The sepals may be fused or free and symmetrical or asymmetrical. In some plant families like Liliaceae, it is not possible to distinguish between sepals and petals, and these structures are called as tepals. So these are the sepals. Okay, green colored structures, and it gives protection to the flower parts. Okay, next one, coming to the corolla. Corolla is colorful parts. So the corolla of Kerala is called it as petals. So some flowers having large showy petals, but in some families such as the grasses, the petals have become very reduced. It is also free or fused and termed as polypetalous and gamopetalous. Next, very important topic in the floral characters we have to write in the families. So that is the aestivation of floral parts is very, very important. So, aestivation is different types. So, mainly five types of aestivations are very, very important. So, it is a mode of arrangement of accessory floral members, that are sepals, petals, or tepals, that means perianth, with respect to one another in a flower bud. These are following types. They are volvate, twisted, imbricate, quincuncial, and vexillary. In the volvate aestivation, all the sepals or petals are arranged in a whorl, is called as volvate aestivation. In twisted aestivation, all the five petals are equally in and out. Five are in and out. Okay, 5 petals are in and out. In the imbricate aestivation, one petal or sepal is completely in, one is completely out, and three are in and out, one completely in and one completely out. This type of aestivation is called as imbricate aestivation. And the quincuncial aestivation. In the quincuncial aestivation, two are completely in, two are completely out, and one is in and out. That is called as quincuncial aestivation. The vexillary aestivation. In the vexillary aestivation, outermost petal is large and the middle petals are two and the inner petals are connected together. So petals are in three whorls. This is called as vexillary aestivation. So valvate means in this type, the margin of the sepals or petals simply touch each other but not overlap. That is called valvate aestivation. For example, for the valvate aestivation is Mimosaceae. Twisted or contoured. So in this case, sepals or petals are arranged in such a way that their one margin overlaps the margin of the next, and one and other margins is overlapped by margin of the another. For example, Malvaceae. Imbricate aestivation. In this case, out of the five accessories members, one is purely internal and one is purely external, and the rest three are partially internal and partially external. This is imbricate aestivation. For example, for the imbricate aestivation is family Cisalpiniaceae. And quincuncial aestivation. In this case, out of the five accessories members, two is purely internal and two are purely external, and one is partially internal and partially external. For example, for the quincuncial aestivation is Apocynaceae. Yes, spelling is mistake, sorry for this. Apocynaceae. Vexillary, it is a type of imbricate aestivation. Here, out of five petals, the odd posterior one is largest and outermost. It overlaps the two lateral petals, and the lateral petals again is done partially overlap the two smallest and innermost petals. That is keel petals, like this. Valvate, twisted, imbricate, quincuncial and vexillary aestivation. Next, coming to the andrecium, depending upon the numbers and arrangement of stamens, it is classified into following groups. Diplostemonous stamens and obdiplostemonous stamens. First of all, you have to know about the diplostemonous stamens. So stamens occurs in two whorls, and outer one is alternate with the petals and consequently opposite to sepals. For example, Caesia pistula. Here are the stamens, these are the petals. So alternating petal stamen, petal stamen, petal stamen, petal stamen, like this. So stamens occurs in two whorls and the outer one is alternate with petals and consequently opposite to the sepals. For example, Caesia pistula. Next one is obdiplostemonous. When the stamens of outer whorl are opposite with the petals and consequently alternate to the sepals. is called as diplostemonas condition. This is a diplostemonas and this is a diplostemonas. So isostemony, when all the stamens are in one whorl and are equal to the number of the sepals and petals, is called as isostemony. And tetradynamous, stamens are 6, outer 2 are the shorter and inner 4 are the longer, or vice versa. So for example, cruciferae family. Didynamous, stamens are 4, 2 are long and 2 are short. This is called as didynamous. These two are long and these two are short. For example, labiate family. Next, union of stamens. The union of stamens takes place either among themselves or with other whorls. Adhesion of stamens. Stamens may united with other floral whorls like perianth, petals, or gynoecium. Based on the floral organs involved in the union with stamens, the adhesion may be of the following types: epiphyllous, epipetalous, gynandrous. So here are the picture showing sepals, pedicel. This is the pedicel, these two are the sepals, these are the corolla lobes. Gynostesium, two ovaries, annulus, corolla is present. So epiphyllous means stamens united with perianth. Stamens are united with perianth is known as epiphyllous. For example, for epiphyllous is asparagus. Next, epipetalous, stamens are united with petals. Stamens are united with petals. That is called as epipetalous. Epiphyllous, phyllous means stamens united with perianth. Epipetalous means stamens united with petals. For example, for the epipetalous is datura. Next, gynandrous. Gynandrous. Gyne means gynoecium, andro means andricium. So andricium means stamens. Gynandricium, gynandrous. So stamens united with gynoecium. It is also called as gynandrium or gynostegium. Stamens united with gynoecium. Stamens united with gynoecium. That is called as gynandrous, gynandrium or gynostegium. For example, for the gynostegium is calotropis. That is calotropis, gilledu. Belongs to the family Asclepiadaceae. Next one is cohesion of stamens. Usually, three types of cohesions among stamens occur. There are adelphous, monodelphous, diadelphous, okay, polyadelphous. First one is adelphous. So anthers remain free and filaments are united. Anthers remain free and filaments are united. That is called as adelphous condition. Can be monoadelphous, united to form one bundle, example China rose. So monoadelphous, united to form one bundle, example China rose. Didelphous, united to form two bundles, example P. Didelphous. Polydelphous, united into more than two bundles, for example for
Fallidal persis, lemon. Next, syngentious. Filaments are free and the anthers are united. Example, sunflower. Okay, synandrous. Stamens are fused all through their length. For example, cucurbita. Synandrous. Syngentious and synandrous. Attachment of anther to the filaments. Attachment of the anther to the filament. Innate or base fixed. When the filaments are firmly attached to the base of the anther. Base of the anther is called as base fixed. Adnate, when the filaments running the whole length of the anther from the base to apex, from the base to apex, for example, Mycelia species, that is adnate. Dorsifixed, when the filament attached to the back of the anther is called as dorsifixed. Dorsifixed. When the filament attached to the back of the anther is called as dorsifixed. That is Vahinia and Verti. Vahinia variegata is the example for dorsifixed. And versatile. Filament attached to the back of the anther at a point only so that the latter can swing freely. For example, graminae. Okay, ma? Versatile anthers. So, attachment of the anther to the filaments, those are different types. Base fixed, adnate, dorsifixed and versatile. So, in the base fixed, when the anther filaments are firmly attached to the base of the anther, when the filaments running to the whole length of the anther from the base to the apex, that is adnate. When the filament attached to the back of the anther, dorsifixed. Filament attached to the back of the anther at a point only, latter can swing freely, that is a versatile anther. These are the attachment of the anther to the filaments. Next is dehiscence pattern of the stamens. Dehiscence pattern of the stamen. That is a porous first one. Pollens released to the pores. Pollen grains are released to the pores or called as porous. For example, for the porous is brinjal and potato. And the longitudinal pollen released to the longitudinal slit of anther lobes. For example, China rose and cotton. Next one, gynoecium. So, coming to the gynoecium. The gynoecium or pistil is the fourth essential whorl of the flower and may be made up of one or more carpels. A carpel has three distinct parts, namely ovary, style and stigma. The lowermost swollen fetal part of the carpel is the ovary. It is encloses the ovule. Above the ovary, elongated thread-like structures attached to the apex of the ovary. The style end with a round sticky stigma. A sterile pistil is known as pistillode. The number of the carpels in a gynoecium vary in different flowers. Accordingly, the gynoecium may be described as monocarpellary, bicarpellary, dicarpellary or tetracarpellary. What is monocarpellary ovary? It is a ovary with single carpel. Single carpel
is called as monocarpellate. Only one carpel is present, for example bean. Bicarpellate is presence of two carpels. Presence of two carpels like this. For example, solanum. Tricarpellary, it is the presence of three carpels. 1, 2, and 3. Tetracarpellary, it is the presence of four carpels. For example, cotton. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Pentacarpellary, it has presence of five carpels. Example, hibiscus. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carpels. Multicarpellary, it is presence of many carpels. For example, for multicarpellary ovaries, anona. Next, cohesion of carpels. If the number of carpels is more than one, they may be apocarpus or syncarpus. What is apocarpus? Carpels are free. Each carpel has its own style and stigma. Is called as apocarpus. Syncarpus, carpels are united. Example, lady's finger and tomato. That is called as syncarpus. So the ovary encloses one to many chambers called the locules. Usually the number of locules in syncarpus ovary correspond to the number of carpels. Sometimes the number of locules may be doubled. Just example, in Datura, the gynecium is bicarpellary syncarpus with four locules in the ovary. Based on the number of locules, the ovary may be described as follows: unilocular, bilocular, trilocular, tetralocular, pentalocular, and multilocular. Uni means one, ovary with one locule, for example, dolichos. Bilocular, ovary with two locules, for example, solanum. Trilocular, ovary with three locules, ileum. Tetra means ovary with four locules, datura. Pentalocular, ovary with five locules, hibiscus. Multilocular, ovary with many locules, abutilon, example. So these are the different types of ovaries on the basis of locules. Next one is a placentation. So placentation refers to the arrangement of ovules within the ovary. The ovules are attached to the ovarian walls through the special structures called as placenta. So first one is marginal placentation. So here is the placenta forms a ridge along the ventral surface of the ovary and the ovules are born on the ridge. For example, P. This is a marginal placentation. The placenta forms a ridge along the ventral surface. These are the ovules. Axial placentation. The ovary is partitioned into several chambers or locules and the placenta are born along the septa of the ovary. For example, China, tomato, and China rose. Parietal placentation. The ovules developed on the inner wall of the ovary. This is the inner wall. These are the ovules. So, the ovules develop on the inner wall of the ovary or on the peripheral part. The ovary unilocular but in some cases becomes two-chambered due to the formation of false septum. For example, mustard. Next, free centrals. Ovules are born on the central axis and septa are absent. For example, carnation and chili. Basal placentation. Placenta developed at the base of the ovary is called as basal placentation. For example, but the basal placentation is sunflower. Next one is style. The stalk-like structures present above the ovary is called as style. And the base of the style is swollen and forms a structure called stylopodium. And it is giving nectaries. So, kinds of styles: terminal style, lateral style, and gynobasic style. Here are the pictures showing different kinds of styles. So, terminal style is if the style arises from the terminal part of the ovary is called as terminal style. For example, Dadura, Hibiscus, and Solanum. Lateral style, if the style arises from one side of the ovary, it is called as lateral style. For example, mango. Gynobasic style, if the style arises from the base of the ovary, is called as gynobasic style. For example, for gynobasic style is Osimum and Salvia. Stigma. The terminal pollen receptive portion of the style is called as stigma. If receptive pollen grain during the pollination, usually the lobes of the stigma are equal to the number of carpels. Here, the stigma may be unified, bifid, and trifid, tetrafid, pentafid, or multifid. In this slide, you have to observe. This is a stigma is capitate, and this stigma is simple. This is the stigma, anthers and filaments. Okay, this is the receptacle. Next, stigma is capitate, forked and feathery. The round stigma is called as capitate. Divided stigma is called as forked. For example, for forked stigma is tridex. Feathery, brush-like stigma is present in the grasses. This is called as feathery. Next, floral formula. Once the description of the plant is completed, you have to write a special method where few signs and letters are used for writing the floral formula. So, if the bracts are present, that will be designated with symbol BR, bracteate flower. EBR, bract absent, a bracteate flower. K, calyx is symbol with K. And polysepalous calyx, KN. Gamosepalous calyx, KN bracket. Corolla, C. Polypetalous, CN. Gamopetalous, CN bracket. P for perianth, A for andrecium, G for gynecium. G under dash, superior ovary. G above dash, inferior ovary. Male symbol, male flower. Female symbol, female flower. Both the female and male symbols, bisexual flower. Place mark, actinomorphic. Percentage mark, zygomorphic flower. Okay. Next, bracts and epicalyx. BR bracteate, EBR bracteate, ebracteate, EBRL bracteolate, EBRL, E means epicalyx. K calyx, K4, 4 free sepals, K4 united, 4 fused sepals. Symmetry, plus actinomorphic, percentage, zygomorphic. Okay. C corolla, C4, 4 free petals. C for bracket, 4 fused petals. P for perianth, P5, 5 free petals. 5 free bracket, 5 fused petals, P3 plus 3, 6 tepals in 2 orals. So A for andrecium, A5 5 free stamens, A5 bracket 5 fused stamens, A5 plus 5, 10 stamens in 2 orals of 5 each, A0 stamens absent, A infinity indefinite stamens are present, CA stamens epipetalous, PS stamens epiphyllous, G for gynecium, G3 3 free pair carpels, G3 bracket 3 fused carpels, G0 carpels absent, G under dash 2 bracket 2 fused carpels, ovary superior, G3 3 fused carpels, semi inferior ovary, G2 brackets above dash 2 fused carpels, inferior ovary. This is the floral diagram. This is a flower plant, this is the stem, the bract, bracteate, sepals, petals, stamens, these are the bract, and it is actinomorphic and the zygomorphic, these are the sepals united and petals united, and the 5 andrecium, 5 stamens, 5 and pentacarpellary, pentalocular, pentacarpellary, pentacarpular ovary. The hypogynous flowers and the perigynous flower. In the hypogynous flower, ovary is superior. In the perigynous flower, half inferior ovary. In the epigynous flower, ovary is inferior. So here the insertion of the floral leaves, hypogynous, perigynous and epigynous flowers. These are the information about the flower. Okay, ma, this is very useful for the taxonomic floral characters writing. So thank you. Now I'm going to end the class. Stay home and stay safe.